Usa ka masamdong adlaw han Pebrero 4, nahitabo in insidente makadima-dima hinduro. An pagpataya hinusang tao duro kabuutan kan forest ranger Jacinto Maratas, Loloy Kontawagon. Gimpalamadyaan nga lawas ni Loloy makaluluoy hinduro, natad-an na la MacArthur Park an Pebrero 8, ug dinhi nasabtan hiloloy nag-antos duro nga kastigo, pinusil haulo dapit hatalinga, tinudtod pa ang kamao. Ikaw ba nahadlok nga ikaw patukan? Hadton imo tinuntong ang mga binuhatan? Tungod kay hiloloy usa nga principal witness, kadamaan nga raids o kaso hiniligan laging.
Hiloloy tuktok o tangkol pag dumarahan iya serbisyo. Pobre nga forest guard, kinabuhi igimbuhis, pagsumpo, kin mga illegal loggers. Kanay servisyo, tubang, kapindos min, ang sweldo, kada bulan.
Ang Siday actually, it started out as a puplunganon, which is quotable quotes. Ginagamit namin yan as clincher in the early morning news drive, yung balita numero uno din.
Ang contents ng Siday, reflection sa mga sentiments ng tao ba? Ano ito, galing from the heart of the writer.
Ang kinabuhin ang tao. Kinabuhin tao, punuhin misteryo. Damo nga pakiana, nasugod hauli. Hinubagod hiya, ikaw man o ako. Kay ano may pubrik, o sugad man, may ko. Inin kinabuhi, parihoin balon. Nadalagan halab na san, makurin maabo. Parihon pangabuhi, na aswag nalulunod. Danay naman humbas, danay naman tao.
Ini may kukumpara gihapon ito ng tindad. Guhit ang kapalaran, naguburo balikan. Bisan pa daw ikaw, in maabilidad, ayaw pagtapon, bangin ka matuan.
Kita daw sangkay, kalidig itong auto. Ito, in pareho la, kinabuhit tao. Samtang nakaliding, kapalaran tinitigo, kun kinabuhita, ti atras o ti tagto.
Ako nagsisiday ako kay ako sarin ko pa kanina sa ko itong talento na kumbaga Tagalog pag gusto ko malinang magplaris pa itong akong talento. Sarin ko pa maihayag ito akong karyag singon ito adit akong hunahon at adit akong kasing-kasing.
The ones writing the Siday in the native language were those who lived mostly in the rural areas. So some of them are farmers, some of them are, they were unlettered, some of them did not know how to read and write, but they can compose using their ears, no? Using, sometimes they dictate to somebody who can write it down for them. So those in academia, those who were educated, they wrote in another language. Only the people who talk to one another in the native language, in all their transactions, whether personal or public, they were the ones who wrote in the native language. But there was no outlet for this. So that's the background in which the initiative of Misko Studio came in.
Mga kasangkayan, ang akong Siday, parehan ng adlaw, tikang kan Leonora G. Escalona. Barangay 65, Paseo de Legazpi Street, Hiton Tacloban. Ginkaranan aniya Siday nga kamingaw kananay. Hinanay, buutan gud ka upay. Kami iya gin mangnuan, aniya kaguol ngan kapiraw, baliwaray. bisa na niya pagkakaon. Kahinga-kahintal danay.
Kinanay, amon modelo. Hakadigon hapan una-una o kasing-kasing haamon ni Gintutlo. Maupay nga pamatasan o kahadlog haginoo. Diri mawadan ng paglaon sa Diyos mag-amon.
Di ako ito yung nagamit han 1999 nang kamatay na ako nanay nga nagihimo ako tapos nabasa si Wade Hill.
It was the Siday because it was the only, let us say, if you have a wide horizon there, it was the only thing you see in the horizon. It was the only active literary project that was going on in Leyte. Everyone else who wanted to write at that time was writing in English or writing in and maybe in Tagalog, and they were not visible. If there were writers at all, we hear about so and so is doing this, is doing that, but we cannot see him, nor can we see the work. So the only active literary production going on at that time was the PYBL Siday. It also represented for me the courage of those who wrote, who despite the fact that they had no models, nor they had no, the encouragement that Bebs gave to them was really, really insignificant, still they kept on writing.
Kasugbong nira arado og karabaw, sinusurapo an uran tunog og sirak, baliwaray an kapasmuhan lawas, puhunan kusog, dugo luha og balhas. Upod ko hapag-aram an paningkamot, bisan sapatos nga guho an akon sulod, uniporme lubad may tangkop medyo kunot, an akon bulsa waray piso na sulod. Salamat kanan iba pagtamay og pagsuson, kay dinhi ako humugutin kusog, upodan pag-ampo nga makalangpos, makatapos pag-aram na may sulod an utok. Kung gagawa ka ng Siday, kailangan padaanin mo sa puso at saka sa isip. Pag nagtugma ang dalawang yon, makakalikha ka ng Siday. Na re-renew itong paghigugma na mo ni Juan. Nangangalimtan na ba itamong lingwahe sa hay tungod nga na na-adapt naman ko din English, Tagalog. Siya may ito. Pagbuhay ito, ito rin nun nga puplungan.
I don't know how to describe Yolanda. The fierceness of Yolanda was the worst talaga. Ilang taon na ako, 70. Yun lang ako naka-experience ng talagang akala ko nga, I will not survive. Kasi biglaan ang tubig, tumaas. We were prepared for strong winds, but not sea water. Very horrible, very harrowing, and very heartbreaking talaga. Because I lost two of my men who was with me at the time. On duty ako eh. Sabi nga nila, why did you go on board? Bakit ka nag-duty? Total, you can always delegate that. Sabi ko, oh, no. My principle is, and I am trying to teach that to my men. Now, if duty calls, andong ka. Ako ang nakatoka noon eh. So I have to be there. And it was a good thing na nag-duty ako. Kasi ang nawalan ng member of the family, like my technician and announcer, hindi nila sasabihin na nineglect ko sila. Because I was also there. I faced the same predicament. Masakit when I learned that two of my men died. I could not take it. Sabi ko, Lord, why? Ako, I was so devastated when the members of the family came to me. Tapos, tinatanong nila, bakit dati? Anong nangyari? I don't know, masi ako. My survival is also a mystery to me, how I survived that. Hindi ko rin alam. Because nang medyo ano, tumas ng tubig, sabi ko, Lord, ikaw ang bahala. I invested so much in that station. Everything back to zero. They were all washed out by the seawater. Lahat ng pinaghirapan ko doon that I invested, nawala lahat. But all that is nothing to me. Tao ang importante ko, yung dalawa. Minsan eh, ayaw kong tumingin sa dagat.
Nakakaada haapon hin pag-aghat, hin pagsurat, ngan pag-aghat hin panhunahuna, hin maupay, ngan inspirasyon. Actually, usahay nga naging inspirasyon ko para magmatadong anakon tatahakon nga dalan. Kay para anakon kaaradman, madugangan pa, pinaagihan pa mamati haiya, haniya. Kada aga nga programa.
Yung mga magrinig lang kung agin din inakop daw inin mga motorista nga naggagamit it nga mga magaringasa na tambutso. Pasensya na nga daytaton mga kabugtuan nga dahil nga klase hin baga pag ano
we have to tell our audience the truth no matter what. Don't lose your credibility. Huwag ninyong ipagbili yung credibility ninyo kasi that's the end of you para sa akin, ano? And I don't know if they subscribe to that, but that is my belief. You lose your credibility, you lose yourself as a person and your dignity as a person. For me, being credible is the quality that a journalist should have. Kasi kung wala nang makikinig, walang nobody believes you, what's the point of being a journalist? Pinaka-importante para sa akin yung you galvanize this, the sentiments and ideas of our views of the listeners so that an intelligent public opinion can be formed.
Dida, iton aton na pagpaambitayo hinin informasyon nga naton mga servisyo. Kaupo di dito naton mga ka-aksyon. Sugid man, ito naton na partner di engineering Glenn Margalio. Ako yung Louie Quebec. Oming aga, kayo nga tanan.
Justisya para kan Luloy. Justisya para aton kagurangan. Adios sang kay nga paraan, makabut munta kinabuhi nga lagi noon.